Everybody ready for step 8 in our step-by-step makeover? It's time to open our eyes and our palettes for eyeshadow. So I'm going to be doing a very quick daytime look using 3 of my favorite shadows in the mineral pans that are sitting right here in our mineral eyeshadows in our magnetic palette. So we've got Candlelight, Taupe Shimmer, and Pebble. Just nice classics. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with Taupe Shimmer. I'm gonna go in with the Chisel Oval Fluff. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get in what I call boogie check position. Anyone that's had a lesson for me knows that the proper position that I teach for getting your eyeshadow on perfectly is to actually glance down into a mirror like I'm doing right here. Okay, what that does is that opens up the whole lid space so you can see where to put stuff. So I've tapped in 2 taps and I tapped off on my Taupe Shimmer eyeshadow. I'm gonna begin it right in the middle of the lid. Wherever you hit first, you're gonna dump the most color. Then I'm gonna blend it inward and outward and up to the crease. Now, if I just wanted a 1 shadow technique, I could stop here. I could picture this imaginary guideline from corner of nose to the corner of the eye. Keeping that in mind, I could move what's left on my brush up and out parallel to that blend line. Anything falls below that blend line, I am gonna grab my little wedgie and I'm gonna clean it out of there. I can also use the wedge to go over all of my artwork and just bring it to perfection. I think it's really hard to do perfect makeup without the disposables of the little wedgies and also the pointed Q-tips. So look at this. Remember, we put our blush Marvelous up on our brow bone. So this looks like a 2 shadow technique with 1 eyeshadow. So all your medium tones to lighter toned eyeshadows, if you just wanna do 1 shadow all over your lid, blend it up and out, you'll be ready for liner or to go out the door, whip some gloss on. So if you wanna bring in a highlight color, what I like to do is use my highlight color more in the inner corner of my lid and just kind of like a triangle, inner corner and then blend in. You can also do a little bit under the arch of the brow, but that's about it. We're gonna go into Pebble, which I would call my daytime crease color. You can do this technique with any of your medium to darker tone colors. And the darker it is, the more dramatic you're gonna look. So like a night look, you might go into like Starry Night. But for day, keep it somewhere in the middle. So you're gonna go in with the end of the brush. And that's why the Chisel Oval Fluff brush is the best. It works with all the colors. Tap in, tap off. Boogie check position. You're gonna start in the outer ditch. Now the ditch is the crease and it kind of looks like a rainbow, right? It's that place between eyeball and brow bone that you can press into. We're always gonna start at the outer crease or ditch and do little stippling motions working about 3/4 of the way in, okay? Then what you're gonna do is picture your blend line and blend that up and out right over what we just did. A little bit can get blended down to the outer corner of the eye. You can also lift up your mirror and take a little teeny bit just underneath the outer corner underneath for a little accent. But there we have like a beautiful daytime smoky eye. Now I'm gonna go and do the other side with you so that you get double the lesson. I'm tapping in, I'm tapping off. I'm getting in boogie check position. I'm changing my hand position. My right side's always easier. To get to navigate the other side, whether it's with mascara or your shadow, you kind of give yourself a little hug and look down. Hit that taupe shimmer in the middle, blend it in, blend it out, blend it to that little rainbow, up and out. It becomes a dance when you get used to your guidelines and how much to put on your brush. I'm gonna go into my highlighter. I'm gonna put it in that inner corner to add a little brightness underneath the brow because I did it on the other side. I'm tapping in and tapping off with my crease color, starting at the outer corner, working 3/4 of the way in. See how this just becomes a little bit more of a dance? at first start slow and then you can speed it up. And let's face it, like as an artist, I have to learn how to do all your eyes. You only need to learn how to do your own. Now, I feel like I need a little bit of balancing and blending. So I'm picking up the makeup wedge. I'm cleaning anything out. I'm even going right over. It doesn't ruin it. I'm going to define that little outer area there. If it looks choppy, I'm going to just take the little corner of my sponge and I'm going to blend it. Now, another little trick, say you've gotten kind of messy over here. You can open up your step four mineral powder foundation, go in with the end of the little makeup wedge and just redefine that and blend. And that'll bring you back to absolute perfection. Now, we're not getting any fallout down here because we're tapping in and we're tapping off, and this is mineral. We're using really good brushes that are all natural fibers. So what's going to happen is they're going to stick to that. After you tap off, there's nothing to fall down onto your lashes. So mascara first, then eyeshadow, and then our next step, all right, step nine, I don't know what it is, but it's eyeliner. That's going to be like the icing on the cake for your eyes, the final step in eye makeup. So that's up next.